Hey there, everybody, it's AirPirateCid, and welcome back to more Let's Play Castlevania Aria of Sorrow Fisting Hard Mode. In the last episode, I ended up defeating Death, and I had some technical difficulties. In this episode, I'm probably going to end up wandering around aimlessly. Now, as you can easily tell, I've done about an hour's worth of training, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, but overall, it's been around an hour, and I leveled up 10 levels. Just because, for just doing this barehanded and only having the Skull-a-Soul equipped, I'm quite underleveled, in my opinion. Speaking of souls, I'm going to have to drop the Balor Soul for the time being because it costs way too much MP to go with the Were Jaguar, which is basically like a half-assed Balor Soul. So it's basically like Falcon Punching, just not as good, see? 145 like that. So, alright, there you go. Now, as for what I did during my off-screen training was just doing this. Killing nothing but fish heads, and I just got burned again. But just killing nothing but fish heads because they give off 100 experience each. Which is some pretty decent experience if you ask me. So if you walk over there, you get a super potion. And before I continue off any further, I'm going to go back to the past. No, not really. But, no, I'm just gonna go over here and complete this section of the map because it doesn't really serve a purpose, but I'll have to come back to it eventually anyways. So I'm gonna go ahead and complete it now, and I'm failing hard at this, so let's go on ahead and equip the Headhunter's Soul really quick and wait for you. Okay, almost walked right into that one. Aha, there we go. Yeah, if those things hit you with their spear, you will get cursed. And I don't want to get cursed. Getting cursed is a no-go for me. Aha! I kind of half-assed like Falcon punched you right in the kneecap, I guess. Something like that. Aha! Yes. The Were Jaguar Soul is working out pretty well for me right now. Except for right there. Right there, it just kind of missed. Okay, I'm just now looking at this worm. Is that an eyeball that... I've never noticed this before. It has an eyeball for a butt. It has an eyeball for its butt. What the hell? What kind of design is that? It's got an eyeball for an anus, man. What the hell? Oh, man, that's fantastic. Alright, yeah, I'm just gonna stick with the Were Jaguar Soul. It seems to be working out right now pretty well. Oh, by the way, also in the last episode, I randomly just now remembered this somehow. But, I kept on calling Triton, Trident, and after that, for some odd reason, I ended up calling it a toothpaste brand. No, I'm pretty wrong about that. That's actually a chewing gum brand. So, yeah, it's a chewing gum brand, I believe. I don't know where I'm... Yeah, it is. It is. Maybe it's also toothpaste. I don't know. Aha, there we go. Alright, horse is gone. Go over here. Not gonna do anything there yet. Now, that did not feel good, viewers. That was a hiccup burp, if you've ever had those before. It's kind of like where you hiccup and burp at the same time. And it kind of hurts your chest a little bit. No, 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 stay away from me. There we go. Barely got out of that one. Yeah, if you go down here... Hey, if you saw that thing zooming by just now... Oh, we'll get to that later, viewers. That's a monster that you have to have the, Chronomage ability for. You have to have the Chronomage's Soul. Yeah, we're just gonna continue on going up through this way. Ow, you turd. I'm just over here taking it right in the face and failing to hit him. Alright, there, well... The moment I said something about failing to hit him, and now I'm gonna hit the eyeball butthole worm. Come on, bring it on, horse. I win. Let's go ahead and use a high potion, just to be on the safe side, because I don't feel like... I'm not in the mood to die, viewers. Not in the mood to die. Ow, you turd. Let's see, we're gonna go ahead and get the Skullasoul equipped again, just because I know I'll need it later. Never fails, I will need it. Now I thought I almost walked right into that one. Yeah, you know what? Nah, we're gonna go ahead and equip the Headhunter again. Just to kill you. There we go. Alright. Now, for this, oh boy. Aw, man, I'm getting my butt kicked right now. No, when I'm turned to stone. Ugh, let me alone. Let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead and use another high potion, just because I know I'll need it. You're not playing nice. There we go. Oh, by the way, once again, as another note, by the time I'm recording this, I just got up to 200 subscribers, and I wanted to say thanks to all of you who are subscribed to me and actually watch my videos and enjoy my commentary on my gameplay. It really does mean a lot to me, actually, knowing that I have fans out there. So hopefully you watch my Let's Plays, I'm hopefully a positive influence on people, which I don't think I'm completely too positive on that one, but I hope that, you know, I'm not really a bad influence to anyone or anything like that. But I just want to say thank you all for watching these Let's Plays and being subscribed to it and just being a part with me. And I actually enjoy doing these Let's Plays. It's quite entertaining, actually. Oh, crap-a-loney. What do I do? What do I do? Use another high potion, first of all. Because that, the arch... Yeah. Archdemon there would have been a problem if I kept him alive. There we go. Aha, there we go. Now I'm up here. And I'm going to find that little warp point right here. Yeah. Time to go this way. Ooh, let's avoid getting hit by them, man. I already remember... Several times in the past have I been screwed by the gold Medusa head. I just ran out of MP. Holy cow. That's no good. Alright, you. I know exactly how to avoid you. Come on, throw him. Crap. Ugh. That other one started chiming in. Yeah. There's a poison worm, which still has an eyeball for a butt. I still don't know why, but I find that so entertaining. It's hilarious that they have an eyeball on their butt. Okay, this area right here. I'm gonna go ahead and equip the Chaos Ring just to fill up my MP all the way. Alright, that's good. Go back to the Shrumen Ring. Go to Soul Set. Alright, in order to get to this next area, you have to have one of these three souls. You have to have either the Devil, the Curly, or the Manticore. I'm going to be the Curly. Just because I'm getting in touch with my feminine side, viewers. I'm getting in touch with my feminine side. Alright, equip the Undine Soul. And as you can see the symbol right there, that's the Curly symbol. If you run over here, you'll see the Devil. Oh no, that's the Manticore right there. The Devil is up there in the top right corner. Now that's a clue to you that you have to do this. No. Stand right there, Soma. You have to actually equip the Undine Soul and one of the three Charging Souls in order to get to that next area. So, Well, there you go. Now that we're in this next area, we can continue on with more treasure hunting. Yay! So, yeah, I remember whenever I first discovered that, I was just thinking, okay, it's gotta be something or another to do with one of those three charging souls. Which at the time, I think I had the devil soul. So I just went with that one. Ow. And just for comedic purposes, I went with the curly soul for this let's play. Wow, the mud man is throwing mud at you, but for some odd reason, I always think it's like crap he's throwing at you. Haha. Alright, here we go. And you're dead. Let's see. What soul set do I have equipped? Okay, I still have the headhunter. We're good. We're good. Oh, you accursed gargoyle. There we go. There goes one gargoyle. And then after that, there's one more right there. Yeah. There we go. Well, he hit me and I hit him, but I ended up winning. So, I can live with that. I'm not 200% positive if I've actually already shown this room before, like right there where it crosses over, but you have to hit that switch right there. And there at that, well, there you go. You've already unlocked this area. And actually, I think I did show that room before. I'm not 200% positive, but I was saying something or another about there being like the glitch that you could go ahead and activate it, but that's only in Dawn of Sorrow for the DS. Whenever you have to equip the, I forget which knife it is that you have to equip that you do the backstab ability. But you can actually get into a couple of areas early if you have it. It's really fun to do sometimes. Let's go on ahead and, use the super potion because I'll be getting one here again in the, probably in the next video. Oh, you. I hate you. Ow, I walked into that one, so I deserve that. Yeah, let's not get protruded up the butthole by a vine. Jump over that, and jump over that again. There we go, alright. Defeated her pretty easily. There's another eyeball butthole worm. Boy, that was the poison eyeball butthole worm. Ow, how did I get hit if... Never mind. Yeah. Oh man. We're already almost out of time. We've only got a couple of minutes. Because I don't really want my videos to reach the 60-minute time limit anymore. Just because I don't know. I feel picky about it. Just 16 minutes just seems like a random number to go with. So I kind of want to end them at 15 minutes. But depending on where I can find a stopping point and keep on getting hit by these harpies. Come on, where it? I hear her, but I do not see her, so I'm going to forget about her. Go ahead and equip the Skull Assault. Wait. I don't think I equipped this. I don't know why I thought I didn't have the Skull Assault equipped. I go down here. Duck to avoid you. Oh, come on, fish. Stupid fish! Whoa, I managed to avoid that. Haha. There we go, alright. Busted open a wall with my fist. And here is the strongest weapon in the game. And I leveled up, yay! Level 36, always a nice level up. There's never a bad level up, ever. I don't think that there's ever a time that I have played a game and I leveled up and I said, oh man, I leveled up, that's bad. Except maybe in Pokemon. That's the only one that I'm thinking of, possibly. That I may have actually thought that it was like bad that I leveled up. The reason being is because in some cases you do want to stay on lower levels in Pokemon, like level 50 for the battle tower and everything. Or for tournaments, rather. I don't know which one I'm going with on that one. No, I'm cursed! I'm cursed, viewers! Cursed to play Let's Plays forever! I don't know, maybe. Maybe forever. Maybe until the day I die. Which let's hope that's not for a long time. But anyways, I'm going to go on ahead and end the episode right here, seeing as how I've already reached the 15-minute mark. So, thank you all for watching. If you like this video, and if you have not yet subscribed, feel free to subscribe, because that way you'll actually be able to keep up with my videos. Like, every single time I release a new one, it'll be conveniently right there at the start point whenever you load up YouTube. And if you don't really feel like subscribing, well, I guess you can still watch them and entertain yourself with them. Either way, it doesn't really matter to me. So, thank you all for watching. Let's play Castlevania Aria of Sorrow Fisting Hard Mode. I will see you in the next episode.